Hi everyone, I just got back from my weekend trip in Dover. It's my favorite seaside town. So I was with a friend and I had to focus on personal reading, and most importantly we had to just enjoy the moment as celebrating the life, the growth that we have along this soul journey or soul growth. Yes, so I just guided really to do general reading tonight here in the UK. UK time. So just a lot just to share a few things before I proceed with the reading. It's quite a lot of signs and synchronicities while I was there. Yes, when I went back to Dover Castle earlier, I saw the name Michael, and that really, the one that reminded me like Archangel Michael, because yes, I have been connecting to him, so I am just putting this Michael candle in here. Yes, I always connect to my angelic team. All the light beings, spirit guides, and my ancestors as well. Yeah, it's so important to acknowledge their presence and to ask for their guidance and protection. Okay, so another thing I want to share, when I went to the shore this morning, I had a lovely sunrise this morning, and then I saw these two feathers, yes, a black and white feathers. Yes, I have been seeing a lot of feathers, so that might be a sign to you as well. And so important to acknowledge all the signs and synchronicities and be grateful. And yeah, it's a black and white. It just reminded me of the yin yang. Just reminded to have balance. I think balance. Yes, we need to balance our feminine and masculine energies, and also balance between, you know, as awakened souls, we tend to sometimes focus on the 5D. So it's just reminding us to keep balance, being in the 5D and also in the 3D. Yeah, because we're still living in this human form, and also to balance our emotional body. Okay, I think let's proceed now. Let's just clear the energy. So, I'm gonna use the Light Seer's Tarot by Chris Ann. Let's see what messages we can get. Because I did not even plan to really have a reading tonight, but just guided to do. So, we'll just see what's the general energy. Oh, that one. Okay. Okay, let's get this too. Now, this goes here. Ace of Swords. Look at the photo there. It just reminded me of this fossil which I bought from the souvenir shop, the cliff top, White Cliffs of Dover. Look at this one. Yes, it's just really fitting there, isn't it? It's just so amazing, yeah. So, yeah, in here, as you can see, there's the stairs, it's like going deep. Can be like the pineal gland. There's like an opening of your pineal gland being more receptive to guidances by your higher self, by the your spirit team, your ancestors, and there's this discovers like a spiral from outer going in to the core, to the core. Yeah, excuse me. I think there's recent healing, really deepest core healing, and with that there's like enlightenment, like you feel that freedom, like this grow here, like you're free as a bird. Yes, it just reminded me that I have been seeing a lot of birds. Really, I've been connecting to birds, hence the name of the name of this channel is Dove Vibes. And oh, okay, let me just continue. So what else here? Oh, this number, an infinity sign on number 8 there. Yes, maybe number 8, there's like a sun. Yeah, so what I'm getting this is there's really like is a reminder that we are infinite being. You are an infinite being, you're a soul. What you see in the mirror is just the it's just the like an iceberg. It's just the tip of the iceberg, and you're much deeper than that. You're an infinite being. And I think this one here, there could be tendency as well. The other could be overthinking, overthinking, and yeah, could be overthinking things, like being so analytical sometimes with your logic mind. I think that needs to be balanced by connecting deeper. I think that's the recent energy shift that you had gone through, like that is like above light, a sudden click of that light, of the enlightenment, that you have to connect with your soul deeper and to understand more through your intuition, through the higher self's guidance, acknowledging the guidance of that God within you. I think with this Ace of Swords, there's like a sudden movement or a sudden decision, very life-changing one after such realization. Okay, that's beautiful. Yeah, and you keep on climbing up. Yeah, you keep on ascending. Yeah, ascension. And it just reminded me, because this morning me and my friend had to go up on like a long flight of stairs going, it's like a shortcut going to the castle. Yes, that is beautiful. And then let's see here, 9 of Wands. Yeah, there's like, see, there's a light in here as well. So there's really enlightenment that I would say you've been really working hard, and that you've been like getting ready for this big life-changing event that's about to happen. Like, let's see, days from now. Yeah. And just take it as how it resonates to you in your situation. And let's get one more card. Let's see, let's continue more. Speaking of sudden, the tower just had shown there earlier. Oh, this is a picture of my pentacles. One more, please. Yeah, it's coming up again, judgment. So let's get this one. No, let's get that one. Yeah. Okay. Nine of Pentacles. Oh, look at that. There's a. There's a. I think it's a doll. Or a. An owl. Okay, before I proceed, let me just show you what I got in the souvenir shop this time. It's a dove. Yes, it's a dove. It's my friend who saw this, and then she's like, "Oh, Aldina, you might like this one." I said, "Wow." I said, "Yeah, I know it's so it resonates a lot to you because she knows my channel. She also has a channel. Yes, she's writing song and making songs, yeah. And her name is Mikaeli. Look at this one. It's just so amazing. I'm gonna put this on my tree or just put here somewhere on my desk. So beautiful. And look, going back. Let me fold this one. Just so nice with all the stars. Oh, I wanna fly now. Okay, let me just put this one here. Wait. Okay, this is what is on here for a while. Okay, so Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, there is just that joy coming from within you. And you have built your own life, as we say. You have started building your own empire. And nine here is like, yeah, you're just there's contentment, but you know you have this feeling that you are ready to share this with others or with someone else. Soul partnership, divine counterparts. What's that one? I'm not sure you say so, I'm like, I'm like something. Okay. Anyway, yeah, going back to this. So, yeah, there's fulfillment, there's joy, and abundance. And it's just not the pentacle. It started that feeling of abundance emotionally, like from deep in your soul. Oh my god, it's just an orb there. Thank you. Yeah, this is like the mandala which I have in my bag. Yeah, abundance. Abundance, like abundance of love to yourself and to others as well. And it comes into the physical or the earthly, the 3D manifestations. And look what came. Is it from Nine of Pentacles to the Ten of Pentacles? Now I get it, the story of this. So he's like a happy, a lovely, happy family, like divinely protected family. Look at this. I've been seeing a lot of dogs, like in twos. Dog's sign of loyalty, and yeah, just lovely to gonna be like creating this happy and blessed family. It's all I can get. I mean, just take it as how it resonates to your situation. I've been getting this spirit baby vibes with this. Yes, that there's been like spirit baby protecting and connecting you to your counterpart with all these things that you had done along this journey with your own soul journey. It made you ready to have this soul, deep soul partnership. I've been really getting this recently, like I've been open giving, like doing readings, really, because I really prefer that. And this just always like end of the day, like soul partnership vibes kind of thing, really. So now let's continue. Wow, look what we're just about to set aside these cards, and this one's left on the desk, on the table, the Lovers. This just confirmed that it's really about focusing on this soul or romantic partnership. It's because you have done, like, you've been romantic to yourself. You give to yourself what you deserve, the love that you deserve. So eventually it reflects to that soul that you're connected to. That to give that love you've given back to yourself, the importance you give to yourself. Okay, oh, it's popping out. This card is popping out. There's strength in there. Yeah, it's there here. Yeah, it's the infinity sign again. I'm seeing a lot of that. Yeah, thank you. Now, because now let me just think what card we can use next. Let's just use this Island Timer's Love Oracle, because I'm getting these love vibes. Oh, that one fit there. Let's see what more we get. Oh my. Okay, let's just get three. That's enough. First one here, camera. Reminiscing keepsake, perception, learn from the past, make memories. I think it's both you and your the one your soul is connected to. Well, let's just say the masculine and feminine energy, and I think it's the both of you are really, I think you both have shared quite maybe a lot, like memories, like photos, and you've been looking at each other's own photo or memory collection, and it's just that epiphany or aha moments, like, yeah, I think it's for those who have been like connected for quite a few years already, I would say. And it's just this realization that those were just fun vibes, and though there's no such thing as really perfect or smooth sailing connection, but it has helped you both to grow and just realize that, yeah, it's just a lot of memories. And look what came out. Twin flames. Just angel bumps, because I saw this. I did, before I start my recording, I already meditated and prayed while doing the shuffling of the cards to refresh the energy. It says here, twin flames. Balance, yin yang. Oh, wow. Look at that. I just shared it to you earlier. It's like the yin yang. There. Oh, thank you so much. So yin yang, zen, balance, union, duality, coupling, complement each other. Oh wow. The Lovers. Yeah, you just take it as how it resonates to you. You can call it any terms, twin flames, soulmates, soul connection, deep soul connection. But you know, when you know, you know. Okay? This infinity sign as well. Okay, it's here, talking, interested, conversing more, awaited message arrives, text, call, email, hovering. So I think if you've been waiting for communication, reply, or any sort of, like, what I'm getting, this is a 3D message, could be a phone call or chat, that kind of physical communication, 3D communication, it's coming. It's coming. Quick. Yeah. It's just that I think there's just a lot of thinking involved, and I think it's more on the masculine energy. But eventually, he's, because he's been learning to connect with his soul, think because it's the divine feminine that has been doing a lot of work, soul work, inner work. So it just reflect to the masculine energy as well. So let's get the from the, what's it called, this one? The mermaids oracles. Yeah, because it's just having that sea vibes. It's almost full moon now. Yeah, I just had a lovely walk last night in the seaside and I seen this moon. You can still see it here. Oh, let's get now messages from this. How many we can get from this? Oh, oh. Okay, just check. Okay. Ooh. Here, try different ventures and experiences as a way to grow and learn, break free. I think you've been doing a lot. I think you've been connected to dolphins, and I think you really, yeah, there's, you've been venturing, trying different ways to heal yourself and to connect with your soul and to really expand your horizon and learn things regarding to your soul journey. Explore your options. It's time to look at other possibilities. It's a good time to make changes. Yeah, what I'm getting with this is breaking from the routine. Yeah, of what you have been doing. It could be a hobby, it could be anything that you've just really like, you think it's a routine. It could be your work or job, like you've been thinking really like you need to break free from this routine because it doesn't resonate to you anymore. Like if it's a work, people, places, yeah, that's it. I think what I'm getting with this is more like there's a turtle there. I think what I'm getting with this is it's been a slow moving disconnection because I think it's the masculine energy that's been really taking so much of his time with all this overthinking. But I think it's now being urged, his or her, it depends, but just call his for the masculine energy. He's been really pushed, like he's about to grab the turtle now. He's really moved quickly and break free from the routine because just saying like, yeah, it doesn't resonate. It doesn't really fulfill you anymore because your soul wants to break free. That's it. And really go on this path that gives your soul doing your soul mission. That's it. I think the feminine energy has been ready. It's just that this masculine energy needs that push, final push. And bottom of the deck, accept heaven's help. Look at all those birds there. It's like seagulls. Yes, a lot of seagulls when I went to the seaside. Even here in London, can be seagulls around sometimes. Or recently, you've prayed help for help. So get out of the way and let heaven help you. Yes, yeah, so I was just talking to this friend during this trip that, yeah, you have to, like I said, you have to acknowledge the presence of our guides and ask their help and protection because they see the bigger picture, you know. They're working behind the scenes. And even though we have been awakened in this soul journey, guiding others as well, we're still put in such a place that we need to, like, trust and have faith as how this soul journey, our soul journeys are unfolding. Each of our soul journey is unfolding. and have faith. Trust yourself, trust your ancestors, the angelic guides, your light being team. Trust that they are protecting and guiding you, guiding us along this journey. Yeah, so let's just get advice from this feather messenger, divine feather messenger. Just like feathers above here. Just too many. Gotta get them all. Just for you. Hope you're all having a lovely Sunday, lovely weekend. Ego. Okay, let's do this one. Okay, first one, ego. So beautiful. You are learning all aspects of spiritual connection and reaching new heights. Wow. Like you mentioned earlier about ascending, ascension, about this connection first you with your higher self and, you know, spiritual connection with the other soul, your twin flame, your soulmate, you're having this deep soul connection with someone. It's just so beautiful. And then next one here, peacock. Oh, I love peacock. Yeah, and I had recently drawn to this memory. Memory of me with this peacock in all its glory. Like, that taught me patience as well, because and it was worth it because we had to wait there for the peacock to really open his feathers. It was really worth the wait. So inherent wisdom is emerging at this time. Watch it and ready yourself for a rebirth. Yeah, can be significant to you. And also, oh, it's color blue. Yeah, it's so calming. I think there's a lot of blue, clearing of the throat chakra. I've been getting this, like, I think it's the collective, the masculine energy collective. It's just preparing really to open up, like, talk more about it. Than just from over, you know, from thinking too much to seeing it